excited coming off of two big wins, back-to-back wins in the Big Ten, and first time in program history to sweep the conference honors, Rookie of the Week, and a Big Ten Player of the Week. So pretty exciting time right now for the program, and I think the momentum, wanting to try to continue that into this road trip here to Ohio State.
Coach, I just want to kind of get your thoughts. You know, the Big Ten announced, some of its, the plans for next year in terms of, the conference schedule and conference tournament. And, for the conference tournament, everyone won't be going. But right. I kind of want to get your thoughts on just the news. I assume you, behind the scenes, you've known about this. So what do you think?
Yeah, I think it's a really challenging thing when you have, 18 teams in a conference, and we talked through okay it's a party, really, is what it is. But no, I think when we talked through during the conference and meetings and different scenarios, like how long that tournament would go if you had 18 teams participating, I think it obviously puts even more pressure to be in that top 15, and I think that's something that we want to make sure that we take on that challenge and understand the format now is set, and so now you know how you have to kind of attack the season.
And in terms of, there's not really a lot of wiggle room for the conference slate too. Most of the time you're used to facing teams twice.
Yeah.
They're going to be a lot of one and dones for the most part. What did you think about that part of the news?
Yeah, I think, one of the things that in the past, right, you've got, you play a team twice, potentially you know each other a little bit better. I think it'll be interesting to see if you're playing teams one time. And there's obviously some four new members, so new coaches who aren't as familiar with some of our kind of originals here. But I think time will tell really how that really plays out. It's nice when you can go a home and home with someone, and at the same time, I think with the travel and everything else that's to come, I think we're all a little bit of a learning curve here to kind of figure out exactly how this will play out. I think on paper it's one thing, but it'll be interesting kind of the execution of it.
Are you happy with the number of conference games remaining at 18 on the women's side? Do you wish it was expanded to 20, or are you happy with where it's at given that it's getting to 18 teams in the league?
Yeah, I think we've talked about that as a other conference head coaches, and having the 18 and being able to still have your regular non-conference slate that we've done in the past, I think helps to have some kind of ability to get a little bit of a head start, I guess, if you will, in the non-conference and really get into a flow. And then once we get into the conference, I think arguably we're now the best conference in the country as far as competitive-wise. And so really being able to establish yourself in the non-conference and then heading into the Big Ten and knowing how challenging, night in, night out will be.
You talked about, these next two games are on the road. And at very early in various points in the season, you kind of talked about wanting to see your team compete better. That was Michigan, it was Purdue, Iowa. Those were all road games.
Yep.
And I guess I'm wondering, is that coincidence, or is that one of the challenges that maybe faces this team this week? Seeing how they respond in these road environments, just given some of the struggles they've had.
Yeah, I think, if we look back to whether it was Purdue or Iowa or obviously we won at Illinois, but Michigan, we weren't healthy. We didn't have our entire slate in every one of those games. And so I think now that we've got everybody back and we're a couple months into this thing, my hope is that going into this two-game road stretch, that our kids are going to be a little bit more poised and understand like how challenging it is to win on the road, but also what it takes to really compete for four quarters.
And health aside, is there a what area maybe of the your team's play are you hoping to see some, you know, strides in terms of, you know, performing on the road?
Yeah, I think one, we've struggled with turnovers, so I think we've got to make sure that we're taking care of the ball, getting a great shot. Two, specifically with Ohio State, you've got to be able to contain their transition and then be able to break their press attack. And then we'll be playing, obviously, Northwestern again. And I think, you know, again, we didn't have Brooke Schrammick in that game, so I think having a full complement with going on the road at Northwestern, too, will be I'm much happier. I kind of go into battle with a full slate of kids. But, you know, for us, it's also decision-making and making sure that we're controlling tempo, all those things. I think we've obviously have, you know, great player in Sarah Williams and can really kind of has carried us quite a bit. But I think it's also getting even more production from our bench and having the consistency of that starting group as well.
Sarah's kind of been on a hot streak the last couple weeks. What has changed for her, or has she hit a ceiling? Now that you've had a chance to look at that Rutgers film, what is just going so well for her the last couple weeks?
I think that she's actually, and we talked about this quite a bit, just kind of simplified some things. You know, when if you look at some of her earlier games, I think she's, you know, putting together multiple moves and at times was off balance. I think she's really kind of allowed the game to come to her a little bit. I think her teammates are also putting her in some really good positions with being able to hit her on high lows, and teams are battling and she's doing a nice job of getting position. And then, you know, obviously she's hit a couple threes. I think she's worked a ton on her perimeter game, so that helps with her confidence and feeling like she can dominate down there. And obviously, I don't want to say dominate on the perimeter, but that she feels comfortable stepping out to the perimeter and getting a couple buckets up there.
And along the lines of Sarah, one thing she's really done well this year is, you know, in terms of not fouling as she's blocking shots. And you know, I didn't look up your shot blocking total as, you know, as a player, but can you just speak to the challenge?
114.
I'm sorry?
I had 114.
Oh, okay. Well, she's about to pass you then, I think.
And she should.
Yeah. But can you just speak to the challenge of a player learning to do that?
Yeah, I mean, I think it's definitely a timing thing. It's there's a discipline piece with it too. You know, like you said, her understanding when and not, she kind of got baited. We talked about this after the Rutgers game, into that fourth foul. Like she was disciplined, and then she was like, "Nah, I think I can get it," and she didn't. So I think there's still that her understanding kind of when and where to apply that type of you know, skill set. But I think it's also just the mindset of kind of protecting the basket, being a rim protector, and understanding that when players come in there too, they're fearful to go against her also. So I think it's a combination of, you know, skill, timing, and also maybe there's an intimidation factor even before, you know, you step onto the court.
How impressed have you been with her efficiency offensively these last couple games? Obviously, defensively huge, six straight double-doubles, tied her career high, but she's just been shooting the ball at such a great rate and get that a lot with the look she does, but still to convert that when it's been a issue kind of team-wide earlier in the season, just how impressed have you been with that from her?
I think it's super impressive, if that's the right adjective. But, no, I think for her, it's really she's setting the tone for the rest of the team, and she understands and takes that responsibility really, you know, heavily, and understanding, like, if she can get high percentage looks, then she wants to be able to finish it. She puts a lot of pressure on herself, and I think she's got the highest expectations for herself. I have high expectations for her as well. But I think, yeah, her being that efficient just helps our team, right? Because we are going to go how she goes, and if she's getting easy buckets and she's knocking in shots, I think that really helps to kind of get the whole team's momentum going.
Yeah. Obviously, go to Columbus Thursday. So not to look ahead, but you guys... But having Northwestern right afterwards, after a tight game here at home, is it nice to kind of get the second half of that home and home right away against them with kind of that that home loss to the Wildcats in the back of their minds?
Yeah, I mean, I think, you know, anytime you lose to anybody, I think that you want an opportunity to see them again. I think, you know, it speaks to kind of what you were asking about with not having the single plays for next year. Sometimes you're not able to get that until the next time around. But, no, I think for our kids, yes, we've got to take care of business at Ohio State, but then know that there's a quick turnaround to Northwestern, and we're familiar with what it is they want to do. And like I said, I think feeling like when we're going in, you know, full tilt, that we have a really good opportunity to really split that series.
Oh, and you kind of touched on health, but I assume Tessa Grady, is she
back? Yeah, she's back to 100%.